So it's the 16th of I've forgotten the month. 16th of July. And I'm making my way down to the station for another protest. Just had a change of government. David Cameron resigned, hallelujah. And Theresa May is now the Prime Minister. Usual guffawing by the ruling elite. I think they had about 2 or 3 days on the referendum, 2 or 3 days on the election of the new Prime Minister, which was completely undemocratic. She wasn't voted in. The person that was going against her stepped down, so she was left as the only candidate, so therefore she was put into being the Prime Minister, which isn't any voting going on, nothing. So it was displayed as being one kind of narrative, which was they're going to have an election, 7 people put themselves forward, they had a vote, and then it went boiled down to two, with people stepping out all the time. Michael Gove was one that stepped down. And it looks like, you know, it was all done above board and officially. But it was undemocratic because no one voted for that particular woman outside of the Tory party. So basically, the Tory party had the leader that they wanted, who then, when she went and saw the Queen and got on her knees, she, symbolically, she then came back to the country and made a lot of promises, as they usually do. This all sounds good. And yeah, and then she, well, she's now the Prime Minister. I think some of the rhetoric around the referendum and the election for a new Prime Minister has been particularly nasty on occasions. 2 different factions of people saying one is right and the other is right. Same with the Tory election, or so-called election. Some people saying they're right and other people saying they're right. And the way that I look at it is, if everybody's going into government to do the best they possibly can for the people of the country, whether you are unemployed, to a millionaire, to a child, teenager, elderly person, own your own house, etc., etc., then why do you need to have 2 different sides? You know, you can have a difference of opinion, but you don't need to have 2 different sides. So I'm not saying you should have a dictatorship, but it's almost an illusion. It's like an illusion of having sides. And if you're just all working towards the betterment of all people within your country, you don't need sides. So I think government is only in place because of unscrupulous people. And those unscrupulous people are within government. We've got a problem with the Labour Party at the moment, with Jeremy Corbyn being cooped by the Blairites, or whatever you want to call them, the right, who basically have made a very nice person well, it's been very vindictive with him. Since he was elected, well, since before he was elected, the guy has been made to look like as if he's some sort of devil. And all the guy's saying is he doesn't want to be regarded just as the leader. He wants to lead the party, yes, but to share the responsibility of the Labour Party, so there's more equal say in what goes on. And if you've got someone with a big ego, then they're not really going to allow that. So you need someone with a much more placid ego to allow that kind of government. So he would be, in my opinion, the perfect person for this particular new way of doing politics. So So the Labour Party are having this invite, I suppose, if you like, and it's all kind of got nasty. A lot of people joined Momentum. And in joining Momentum, that's creating a vacuum. And within that vacuum, it's producing a momentum, which is why they're called Momentum. So, as far as I know, because I just recently joined the Labour Party, as far as I know, we're not allowed to vote because we're regarded as infiltrators in some way. So what they've said is we've got to pay £25 within a 2-day period where we can register and vote, which seems a bit peculiar because I paid £3 to join the Labour Party and I'm an anarchist, so. Well, I'm not labelled as an anarchist, but I don't follow mainstream parties. But I thought this guy, trying to make a difference in a way that kind of resonates with me. So, not only that, they've told their own party members they can't have meetings while the election is going on for the leader of the Labour Party. Also, it is alleged that someone threw a brick through the window of Angela Eagle's Labour Party headquarters, or her near constituency, which it stinks, absolutely stinks, because if he was going to attack, I mean, just throw a brick through a window, because as far as I'm concerned, that just sounds like children or teenagers. That's what that sounds like to me. Or the other side of it would be that someone didn't want to make too much of a thing, but enough to jump all over it and put it in the papers and present it as some sort of attack on the right side of the Labour Party, which is what basically happened in the papers after that. But no one's been arrested. So, we'll wait and see if anybody is going to be arrested for that. But it's like anything, isn't it? If you go and do something, whether it's you're on a protest, whatever you're doing, and you break the law, the so-called law, then you'll be arrested for it, wherever you are. or whatever you support. So, so that's kind of where we're at in with British politics. So it's around the world, and there's been a coup in Turkey. Well, it's been a coup and there's not been a coup. A military coup, so I don't know about that. There was an attack in France. We don't know that much about that. So, yeah, I mean, around the world, politically, it's quite incredible times to be living in. And yeah, and I'm going to attend a protest today by the People's Assembly against austerity. There's an emergency one. So I wasn't expecting to be going up today. So I'll be doing that today. Keep it in your video diary. As I go along. So just gonna cross the road. Wait, I'm gonna get run over. Yeah, so I'm gonna be doing that and then keep a video diary today to try and give you a taste and feel of what it's like to want change and very limited way of doing change. So protest at the moment seems to be the only way that we can do it. And being creative, well, creative protest. Thank you. And so yeah, anyway, I'm going to be doing that. Grab a banner, walk with some people down to wherever we're, I think we're going to Westminster. Got to go up to BBC Centre. And yeah, so Hare Krishna. Namaste. Peace out. Zoom in. So I'm going up to protest. Nearly there. Got me banner to show you. Sorry about this. It's my banner to fire Tory roll. I used to bring the own banners, but let's see, a BBC Centre. I just made my way out. Looks like it's going to be a big protest, which is good. Let's try and get to where I'm going to. Just up there, BBC Centre. So I'll keep recording. Just see the process there. So just where that building is. What kind of building is that? Regency. 17th century building, possibly. Not sure what it is. You can see the protest there, it's well attended. I'm gonna really warm day today, actually. That's the start of the process.
They increased the number of immigration controls, racist immigration controls. They were locking up asylum seekers and migrants. They were at it, just the same as the Tories are at it right now, yeah? So we need to change that. All right, that's the question that needs to be answered. How are we going to get rid of racism in this country? We've got to get rid of imperialism and capitalism. And if the Labour Party is going to get in the way of that, then they're just going to have to go as well.
This is a protest. Got the end of someone's speech.
This is an open microphone, people. We're the revolutionary communist group. We've always operated an open microphone. This mic belongs to the streets, so come and use it. Feel free. Everybody's welcome.
There we go anyway. I'm gonna sit down, have a cigarette, because it's not started yet, and I'll come back to you in a moment. Namaste, Hare Krishna, peace out. Thank you. slowly but surely.
Thank you.
Tories out. 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 Tories out.
Tories out.
Tories out.
Tories out.
Tories out.
Tories out.
Fire!
to Trafalgar Square. So I'm gonna walk past Nelson's Column. It's a very big demo. And make our way down to Whitehall, or down Whitehall, to Parliament Square. So we're at Trafalgar Square, it's Nelson's Column. We'll pass this many, many times now. And into Whitehall, see if I can get a shot. Of the consciousness, whatever that might be, for each individual. Thank you. see his work on up to see what he looks like.
Thank you.
Westminster. Just walking up now. Just coming in now. So. People coming to the square.
Thank you. massive coup by a section of the military. And as a result of this, over 200 people have been killed or injured. The coup is to be attempted by some sections of the military, but so far we're hearing news that almost 3,000 soldiers have been arrested. This incident is a reflection of the clash in Turkey between the oppressive forces. This is not in the interest of the people of Turkey. The Erdogan, the current president, has laid the foundation for war and has declared war on all three oppositions, whether it's the LGBTs, whether it's the trade unions, whether it's the environmentalists, and whether it's the people on the left. He's determined to take part, control of all the powers, and he wants to almost impose his rules. Now, on the night of 15th of July, the people protest took over the state TV channel, TRT, and announced that they're taking over the administration of the government. On the other hand, the radio and television regulator, RTÖK, under Erdogan's control, shut down broadcast of Hayat and Sesi and Halk TV, which are considered to be in the opposition. At the same time, the soldiers attempting a military coup raided another TV channel and newspapers. Friends, let's make it very clear. We in the Europe and people of Turkey say no to military coup and no to an authoritarian regime. We want a secular and democratic Turkey. This conflict of competing interests between some sections of the military and the ruling MKP is not in the interest of people. We stand against these forces and raise the common demands of the people of Turkey for a secular, democratic and free country. And on this note, we ask you for solidarity to show with the people of Turkey. Thank you very much.
I'm very sorry for the coming, but I'm just a messenger. Let me send another message. Because very much has to do with us today, I want for your understanding. I want to read a message from Jeremy Corbyn, bracket, JC. He says, dear friends, sisters and brothers, a year ago, the massive anti-austerity march showed there is a chance to do politics differently. I believe it's a time for all of us to understand and to do the politics in different ways. Austerity is a choice, it's not necessity. For answer, a clear answer for that, for all of us, because we said it's a choice, but it's not a necessity. That means we can do things in different ways. Our answer is to stand in unity, in solidarity, and organize campaign for all to make our country to be a very good country.
Support the demo.
Where all of people are coming
sorry, I was
together.
Coming already.
Stand for one, each other, for a good and for the future of our United Kingdom. And the last word from Jeremy Corbyn is said, I look forward to see you all at the campaign event on this summer. As you know, everything is going on together. We can win it together. We can make a difference. Thank you very much, Jeremy Corbyn.
can have a wander around. Dennis. It's the evil place.
This is the same place.
Thank you. You should take a picture of us.
Your podcast is like rising tuition, like cost. Has nothing to do with people's answer. Like they didn't vote for that. Like or anything.
So then, what they did is they shut down main.
The cordon of steel over there. Lots of police wagons, probably about 10. Protecting us from what? such an imposing building.
It's more stereotyping of dogs.
So I'm just having a wander around after the protest. Just having a look at. So never really looked at the Houses of Parliament. Something I've ever done. I can't say this is something I've ever done. What does that say? I don't know. Trespassers on this site is a criminal offence. This is a protected site under section 128 of the Serious Organised Crime and Police Act. CCTV in operation. So always quite interesting. I always think when you walk around London, the different quarters, and this is the political quarter. With all the government buildings, they go from here down Whitehall and the surrounding area. But as you go further on, you got Whitehall, go up to Trafalgar Square. You get the embassies, and if you move on you get the West End with the shops, and you get like the business centres, then you get the courts, and the banking centres a little bit further on in the square mile. But yeah, this is the political centre, so it's Big Ben. So I've never really wandered around. The protest has gone off quite well as a protest. I don't think that it's going to change that much, but what it does do, it makes you feel like you're doing something rather than sitting indoors moaning about the government actually trying to come out and do something. And protest is the only means of doing it at the moment. Direct action is what we probably would recommend first. Anyway, I'll speak to you later. Hare Krishna. Namaste. Peace out. So I was just wandering around Westminster and I was just looking at the trees. Beautiful trees they've got inside Westminster. Look, there's about 4 or 5 of those around. And you've got these, kind of like these trees over here. Beautiful. The obsession with cutting grass. I don't know what that obsession is with cutting grass. Very bizarre.